make of the result there in Chicago, eliminated in the first round?
I think it shows, Hala, that the political media have no idea what they're talking about when it comes to the International Olympic Committee. I had to smile. I mean, I've covered this for a long time, 25 years, the Olympic movement, 13 straight Olympics. Not that we're so smart, not at all. But we've been around the IOC. This is the most unpredictable collection of mercurial characters, many of them aging men who you hope they could stay awake through the four rounds of voting or three rounds of voting. And I don't mean to be mean to them, but it's just such a bizarre group of the oldest of the old boys clubs. I don't think they could have cared less if Obama showed up or not. So in many ways, I think we're doing a disservice to the president by making his visit too important. And now if anyone would start to blame him politically for this. This was almost unwinnable, I guess, is what we're seeing, that Chicago was in big trouble from the beginning and probably was saved a bit by Michelle and Barack Obama showing up, adding a little life into what didn't look like a very good presentation today.
Well, let me ask you, what factors do you think the IOC did take into account? And if last-minute campaigning doesn't sway the committee, what does?
I think certainly with Rio, you've heard it already on your show, the notion of opening up a new continent. You cannot say enough about the dream of Rio. I had several members of the Chicago bid team tell me if they go with their heads, they'll probably go for us, Chicago. Mm-hmm. If they go with their hearts, they'll go with Rio. And it's just opening up this continent. What a powerful scene that was in Rio's presentation when they show the map of the world, where all the Olympics have been, 30 in Europe, winter and summer, 12 in North America, winter and summer, zero in South America. That was huge. And, you know, there's only two U.S. members of this group. They really couldn't care less about the United States, I have to say. They like our money, and this does not make them so unusual around the world, does it? And so the reality is I'm sure they were thrilled to see Obama. I wonder about Obama going and spending time with them because it turned out not to matter at all. So
I was going to ask you, you said they like our money. You're American, so you're referring to the U.S. money, but who funds the IOC? Who funds the International Olympic Committee? Where does the money come from, and how much does it matter when it comes to voting for a host city?
It's a great question, and the answer to the last part of your question is it probably doesn't matter much at all. Same with this notion that the TV cares about the time zones. Rio is great for U.S. TV because it's just 1 hour ahead of Eastern time in the U.S. But in general, most of the sponsors are still in the United States, although more are global now, the top big sponsors within the IOC. But most are U.S., and the bulk of the TV money, the huge majority of the TV money, comes from a U.S. network. And the bidding for that will be fierce. It's $2 billion being spent by NBC for the games in 2010 in Vancouver and 2012 in London. So it will go off the charts. But the fact that these games will be in Rio is actually good for a U.S. television network.
Yeah,
the U.S. can be they call it the bank. And every 20 years or so, the IOC wants to come to the bank. Uh-huh. That's why I think Chicago was hoping they wanted to come back this time.
But you know what I find fascinating about the selection, Christine, is that in the same way the G8 has become the G20, in the same way the World Trade Organization now is going to get increased voting rights from developing nations, the world is changing before our eyes. It's really expanding to other regions.
And that is the point that Rio was using in its pitch. Believe it or not, they were using Yes, We Can. And I wrote in my column in USA Today yesterday, actually, saying that Obama may do a great job. He may just absolutely have them in tears, crying. Obviously, he didn't. But, you know, he'll do a terrific bang-up job, as he always does. And then they might feel great about meeting him, and then they'll go and vote for Rio. And that's exactly what happened. Because, in fact, the message of Obama, the message of inclusion and hope, in many ways, of course, the message of Rio. And that's why this world is changing before our eyes. So for U.S. political pundits to be saying that Obama, the deal was sealed, and it was a done deal and had to be assurances because otherwise Obama wouldn't go, I think that shows just how incredibly naive some of those pundits were when it comes to international politics and the International Olympic Committee.